We're going to do about 30 minutes of yoga, stretching, mobility, whatever you want to call it. And this is quite a nice one to do of an evening. You don't have to, it's just quite a nice, just for how slow it goes. It's quite a nice one to do to switch off of an evening. You're going to need a yoga block, if you have one. You probably don't. If you don't have one, you can use a towel. So if you get a relatively big bath towel and roll it up so that it makes like a sausage shape, something that is big enough to come off the floor about this high. And we'll need that at the end. So to start with, you can either come into child's pose, which we'll get into that knees together and feet together. Push your hips back onto your heels and take your arms out in front of you. Take your hands far in front of you and your head towards the floor. So if you can get the crown of your head onto the floor, that's great. Take your elbows to the floor, take your hands to the floor. And let yourself settle in there. If you are coming to your mat with or the floor, if you're not on a mat, if you're coming here today with a little bit more energy, you can come into dolphin pose. So take your elbows to the floor, clasp your hands together. Your elbows are around about shoulder width away from each other and underneath your shoulders. Tuck your toes underneath you and push up into what looks from the back end like a downward dog. So your forearms are on the floor, your elbows are on the floor, and your fists are on the floor. And then push your fists into the floor, and you're moving your chest back towards your knees. Crown of your head towards the floor. If your hamstrings are tight, you can have your knees bent. So just waking up your body. If you're bored of the child's pose, give this pose a go. The hard part of this pose isn't necessarily getting into it, it's the holding it for any length of time. So even if you just get into it for a few seconds, you've won. Deep breath. Come back into child's pose whenever you need. If you've come into dolphin, venture into dolphin if the mood takes you. And then we'll come back down onto our knees, come out of child's pose, and come onto the floor, onto your front. So, make sure you've got as much of your body connected to the floor as possible here, first of all. So let your hips press into the floor. And then see how long you can get on the floor. So I'm going to lift my leg up and push it away from me, as if someone's pulling my leg. So I'm pretending someone's pulling my right leg away from me. So I'm spreading it out across the floor. Same with my left leg. Lift it off the floor, push it away from me along the floor. So I'm getting longer on this floor. And then take your hands below your shoulders, look down, push your hands into the floor, and then plug your shoulders down your back. So it's quite easy to come to this pose with your shoulders hunched up towards your ears. But anti-shrug them down as you push your palms into the floor, anti-shrug your shoulders down, and hug your elbows into your ribs. Push your hips into the floor, squeeze your bum, push your hips into the floor, and then engage your legs. So really squeeze your quads, push your feet away from you, so really strong legs. Keep hugging your ribs with your elbows, and then look forwards, push your hands into the floor, lift your chest up. Keep hugging your elbows into your ribs, mini back bend. Keep your legs really, really strong here. Squeeze your bum, squeeze your legs. Then come back down. Take your forehead to the floor. And then this time you're going to take your hands behind you with your palms facing the ceiling. Look forwards again. Hook your elbows towards your ribs. Pull your shoulders down your back. Engage your legs really strongly. Squeeze your bum. Lift your legs off the floor. Lift your chest off the floor. Push your hands towards the ceiling. So it's almost like you're trying to fly off the floor here. Get off the floor as much as possible. Squeeze everything. Push your hips into the floor. And then the only thing that should be pushing into the floor, everything else is lifting up. Then come down. Look towards your right. Put your head on the floor. Turn towards your right. Relax everything. Take deep breaths in and out. Try and switch everything off. I'm going to do it again. So look at the floor. Lift your shoulders. Lift your shoulders up towards the ceiling and then back, down your back. Palms face to the ceiling. Lift your legs off the floor. Squeeze your bum. Push out through your feet. Super strong legs. Lift your chest higher. Look forward. Squeeze your ribs off the floor. Lift your hands off the floor. Get as high as you can. Squeeze, 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 squeeze everything up. Everything off the floor. Good. And then come down, look to the left. And relax and looking back to the floor again. Switch everything off. Deep breaths in and out. And then take your hands, lower your shoulders. Lift up onto all fours. And then come up on your knees. Your knees are about hip distance away from each other, so I'll come so you can see me. So your knees are about hip distance. And then we're going to tilt back. So take your hands, come here again so you can see me actually. Take your arms out like goalposts. So you've got your elbows along the same line as your shoulders, and then your hands are down the same line as your elbows. So we're not tilting them forwards. We've got them all at right angles. So hold there, squeeze your bum, push your hips forward. So we're not having our bum sticking out. Squeeze your bum, tuck your tailbone under, push your hips forward, squeeze your belly in. So stand up straight and strong. Lean back, push your chest up towards the ceiling. So mini back bend here. And then bring your hands to hold onto opposite elbows in front of you. And then we're going to lean back. So you're moving as one. Lean yourself back. Really, really strong quad strengthening stretch. Lean back, lean back, lean back. Come back up. Make those goal posts again. Lean back. Look up towards the ceiling. Push your chest towards the ceiling. And then hold onto opposite elbows again. And lean back. Support yourself with your quads. Really hard on your quads. Further back you go, the harder it is, unsurprisingly. Come forwards, goalpost arms, lean back, look up, push your hips forward. Good, so then come back up straight, hold onto opposite elbows again, lean back. Support yourself there at the hardest point, come back forwards, we'll do it one more time. Goalpost arms, squeeze your bum, push your hips forward, lean your chest back and up, open your chest, and then come back up, last time, clasp your hands onto your elbows and lean back, come forwards again, good, well done, take your hands to the floor. Look down at your hands, they should be shoulder width apart. Look at your fingers, your index fingers, they should be pointing straight towards the front of the room. So your index fingers shouldn't be pointing towards each other, they should be parallel. So it might mean that you need to turn your hands out ever so slightly. Index fingers parallel. Push down into your thumb and forefinger, that L shape that your thumb and forefinger makes. Tuck your toes under, I'm going to push up into downward dog. So I'm not concerned about how straight you get your legs here. You can have your knees bent as much as you want to.
Look in between your hands, first of all. So look in between your hands. Get a deep bend in your knees. So I'm concerned at the moment that you push the floor away from you and push your hips up diagonally towards the corner of the room. Then take your ears inside your biceps. And then if you feel nice and straight here, your belly might be over the thighs. My belly is pushing into my thighs here. But I've got a straight line between my wrists and my hips, and that's what I'm looking for. If you feel okay here, take your legs a little bit straighter so that you feel a hamstring stretch. Take deep breaths. Relax your neck. Let your head be heavy. Breathe in and out through your nose. Then look forward between your hands. Walk your hands towards your feet. Take your feet hip distance. And we'll hang here. So we're going to clasp our elbows again. Just like we did in those lean back quad stretches. So clasp your elbows. Hold on to them. And let your arms flop forwards. Let your arms be heavy. They're pulling out of your back now. Ground down into your feet. So let your feet feel really strong. Let them magnify to the floor. Take deep breaths. And then slowly come up to stand. Well done. Okay, let's do some standing positions. So I'd like you to take your right leg back into a lunge. And then set your right heel down. So if I'm in a lunge, my heel's pointed towards the ceiling. I'm going to take my heel to the floor and point my right toes diagonally on a 45 degree angle back to the right. But my left foot is pointing forwards and my left knee is pointing forwards. And it's straight over my ankle. So I'm not letting this knee collapse in. When in doubt, take your hand to the inside of your knee, push it out, try and keep it there. And then we're going to make these goalpost arms again. So face the front of your mat, so you're facing over your front leg, making goalpost arms again. Stand up and straighten your arms. Bend back into your knee, goalpost arms. Stand up, straighten your arms. Bend into your knee, goalpost arms. Every time, if you flow through this while I'm talking, so you stand up, straighten your arms, and come back down again. And every time you come back down into the knee bend, try and get a little bit further towards the floor. So you might find that you need to get a bit more distance. You might find that you need to take your feet further apart. You bring down and up. Down and up. Try and get nice and deep. Okay, let's stay in the bottom position. Take your hands, clasp them together behind your back. Then you're going to aim your torso to the inside of your left leg. So come down, keep your leg, back leg straight. Come down inside your left knee. Good. So you're trying to get your left shoulder to the inside of your left knee, nestle it in there. And then come back up, keeping your leg straight there, leg bent. And straighten into your front leg. Let's get a little closer with these feet. So bring your front foot in and your back foot in. And then keep your left foot pointing towards the front of the mat and your right toes pointing at 45 degrees. And then we're going to make a windmill position. So we should all know this one. Push your hips back. Take your left hand to your left leg. So it might touch your shin, it might touch your ankle, it might touch the floor. We want distance between our armpit, our left armpit, and left hip. So if you just manually touch your left hip, push it back, and your left armpit, and it's that side body down here that we want to feel like it's lengthening. So we're not crunching down into it, we're not squishing it and compressing it. We're getting length here. So you're pushing your left hip
back. And your left armpits and shoulder kind of comes forwards. So when we've got that distance, take your right palm to your lower back and look over your right shoulder and hold it here. Take deep breaths. Look back down at the floor. And using the strength of your legs, let go of your leg with your hand and stand up. Good. And let's get a bit more distance again between these feet. So shuffle them further apart. And then point your right toes towards the right this time. So they're not diagonal anymore, they're pointing out towards the right. And your left toes are pointing towards the left again. Sink down into your left leg. Get enough distance so that you've got a straight back leg. And this thigh bone is as parallel to the floor as you can. Take left elbow to left knee. Good. Left hand to the base of your spine again. Right hand, or left and right, so notoriously awful. Right hand to your the base of your spine. Look over your right shoulder. Good. Take deep breaths here. Stay here, or you can take your left hand to the floor inside your left foot for a bit of a deeper stretch. But elbow on knee is fine. Push your chest forward, mini back foot. Good. Deep breaths. And then we'll come back up again. So pushing down into your feet, stand up. Good. And then point towards the front of your mat. So both feet are pointing forwards. Come into a lunge. So in a lunge, your heels up, your back heels up. The leg is straight, and we're going to come all the way down onto your back knee. Untuck your back toes, take the top of your foot to the floor, and then sink your hips down. So take your hands behind your hips and push them down. Good. Squeeze your elbows towards each other. So my palms are in the back of my hips now, they're kind of in the top of my glutes, and I'm pushing myself down into the stretch and squeezing my elbows towards each other. And I'm going to come into a twist from here. So take your right elbow and push it to the outside of your right knee. So you want to squeeze your belly out of the way. Well, I do anyway. Squeeze, wiggle yourself into it. Right elbow outside of the right knee. Take your hands into either into a prayer position, or you can make a platform with your right palm and a fist with your left palm, and push your fist into that platform. Look over your left elbow, and you're twisting. Keep your hips coming down low, so try not to push your hips back as you do this. Keep your hips as low as you can. And then take your hands to the floor. Tuck your back toes under, and here's a real test for you. You're going to step forwards. One big step. Bring your right foot to meet your left foot, and you're going to land in a forward fold. Step forward, forward fold. Good. Okay. Gather yourself. You're in a standing forward fold. Your feet are about hip distance. And one leg probably feels very different to the other right about now. So let's remedy that. Step back with your left leg. And come up to stand in a lunge. Remember, look at the distance between your feet. So we've got a parallel front thigh. Toes are pointing forwards, knees over your ankle. And then take your back heel, put it on the floor. So your left toes are pointing 45 degrees to the left now. And then you're going to point your torso forwards. Cactus arms. And then we're going to straighten our leg and our arms and sink back down again. Goalpost arms, straighten front leg and arms, sink back down, goalpost arms, straighten leg and arms,
sink back down. And each time you sink back down, we're trying to get a little bit deeper. Stand up. Sink back down. Try and breathe in when you stand up. And breathe out as you sink down. One more time. Breathe in. And breathe out. Good. So stay in your lowered position. Clasp your hands behind your back. And then you're going to lean forwards. And your torso to the inside of your right knee. Push your right shoulder into your right knee. Look at the floor. You won't hold it here for very long. So you should feel a really strong sensation, should we say, it's probably the best way to describe it, and you're right here. And then let's stand up. You can straighten your front leg. And then take your feet a bit closer towards each other. And we're coming into our windmill position. So you're going to push your hips back and lean forwards. Take your right hand to your right shin, ankle or floor. And the first thing we're going to focus on is getting length between right hip, which is coming back, and right armpit. Good. So find somewhere that feels safe to hold on to. And when you've got that, take your left hand to the base of your spine and look over your left shoulder. Keep pushing your elbow back. Deep breaths, don't hold your breath. Push your feet into the floor. And engage your legs, push your feet into the floor, come all the way up to standing. And then we're going to make a bit more distance again between our front and back foot. So take a little step forwards, shift the back, bend deeply into your front knee again. And then take your right elbow to your right knee. And then your left hand will come to the base of your spine again, and we're going to open. Look over your left shoulder. Keep bending deeply into your front leg, keep your back leg super straight. Stay here if you want to stay here, or you can take your right hand to the floor inside your right foot. In which case, push your arm into your knee to keep that knee pushing open. But it's fine to stay on your elbow if you want to. Keep this knee nice and deep. Push into your feet, stand up. And then let's face the front again. And we'll come to a lunge. So you're taking your heel off the floor now. So your heel's lifted in a lunge position. And we're going to come all the way down. So take your back knee to the floor. Untuck your back toes so your foot's flat on the floor. Take your hands to the back of your hips and push your hips forwards. So sink down. Pelvis is coming forwards and down. Squeeze your elbows towards each other. So we're taking our left elbow to the outside of your right knee. So wedge yourself in again. It might not come naturally, you might not be able to completely get all the way across your knee. So I'm going to hold onto my thigh and I'm going to push myself in so that I've got my elbow to the outside of my knee. I'm going to make a platform with this left hand and a fist with my right hand. I'm pushing my fist into my platform and looking up over my right elbow, keeping hips coming forwards and down, and breathing. There's not very much space to breathe here, but try.
come back to the floor, hands to the floor. And then we'll try that graceful, bouncy spring forwards again. So tuck your toes under, lift your knee, look slightly forwards, and bring your left foot to meet your right in forward fold. Deep hip distance. Let your body catch up with what you've just asked it to do. So both sides should feel quite even now. Take your hands to your shins. Push your hands into your shins. Straighten your arms. Point your chest to the floor and look at the floor a few feet in front of you. So feel like your body is making a right angle now. So we're not folding forwards completely. We're making a right angle. So push your palms into your palms into your shins. And then let's come all the way down onto your mat. So sit down and we're going to lie down. Take your heels really close to your bum. Squeeze your shoulders underneath you. Feet parallel, knees parallel. Push your palms into the floor. Squeeze your bum. Lift your hips up off the floor as high as you can. Keep squeezing your knees towards each other like they've got a squishy ball in between them. Dig your heels into the floor. Clasp your hands underneath you. Get your palms together if you can. So palms together, hands clasped. And then wiggle your shoulders underneath you even more. So tuck your shoulders behind you. Push your clasped hands into the floor and lift your hips up even higher. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Hold it here. Pushing everything up. And then come down. And then hold on to your, or find, grab your block or your rolled up towel or any foam roller. I had a thought you could use a foam roller as well. Lift your hips up again. And then you're going to place your implement of choice at the top of your glutes. Back of your hips, so that base of our spine position where we've been putting our hand. So you're going to rest your hips on there. So it should feel like your thigh bones are pulling forwards. So the direction that they're going, because they're heavy, is forwards, spilling over the top of your block. And then your spine is draping backwards. So we're getting a pull of each half of your body away from each other. Take your hands to the floor, palms to the floor. If it feels nicer, I always think it feels nicer, take your arms overhead. Shrug your shoulders down your back to make space in your neck. Take deep breaths here. So you might need to move your block around a little bit just to find where that sweet spot is where feel like you can release. So really far down the base of your spine, but not too far so that it's on your bum and it feels like the whole of your spine is falling inside the block. So it should feel like half of your body is spilling that way towards your knees and half of your body is spilling back towards your shoulders. Take some deep breaths. I'm going to hold it here. Near your phone, you can, or whatever you're watching this on, you can pause it here if it feels nice and just hold it for 10 breaths. If you're not managing to find a spot where this feels beneficial, you can abandon your implements, your block, your foam roller, or your towel, take your hips back down, take your the soles of your feet together. Push your feet together, push your heels towards you, and let your knees fall open, and you can hold it here. Either way, feel free to press pause and just hold it here for as long as it feels useful. And then the last thing we're going to do is take your right ankle onto your left knee.
and then pull everything in towards you. Clasp your hands around your left knee or around your right foot, whichever feels accessible, and pull everything in towards you. Squeeze, 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 trying to get your right ankle towards your left shoulder. And then change sides. Left ankle, right knee, pulling it all in. Thread your hands through, hold on to your right knee. If that's not accessible, just hold on to your left foot. And squeeze everything in towards each other. So make yourself as small as possible. Feel a really strong stretch in your left glutes. You can squeeze your head up if you want to move your foot, or keep your head on the floor, whatever feels nice on your neck. Squeeze everything in. And then let go. Both feet back to the floor. Take your feet wide and let your knees touch. Deep breath in, deep breath out. And then you can stay here for as long as you want, as long as you've got. Or you can get up from here and go about your day, your evening. And I hope you enjoyed that. I did. Well done. Good luck.